We think you'll enjoy hearing Rod Roddy, Dorothy Malone, inside KNews Information, a part of our great news effort here at KNUS 99 on the FM dial.
KNUS Dallas.
Back at Soldier's Field, Chicago, the world champion Cowboys trailing the all-time All-Star 7-3 on Bronco Nagurski's 9-yard burst down the middle, an irresistible force. And here now comes Lou Groza's kickoff as the Cowboys have this time Bob Newhouse and Cliff Harris deep around the goal line. And this one by Groza is through the uprights and completely out of the end zone. Harris and Newhouse just looked over the shoulders and watched it go by. Groza, perhaps the greatest place kicker the game has ever known, got the foot almost completely through that football. It went deep, deep behind the end zone line. And so the Cowboys go back downfield, trailing the Stars 7-3 under these leaden gray Chicago skies. And they'll have it first and 10 on their own 20-yard line after that long, beautiful kickoff by Lou Groza. The Cowboys will have their starting formations in there. Sellers, Neely, Nylon, Manders, Nyan right in the line. Morton, Garrison, Hill, and Parks in the backfield with Mike Ditka as the tight end to bring in the signals. And Morton, who will play the first half and Staubach the second, brings his blue and white teammates up the line at the 20 with 3 minutes 50 seconds yet to play in the first quarter. Cowboys into the eye, and Morton has as his setbacks Garrison and Hill again, with Bob Hayes now in there at wide receiver, Spelling, Sellers, and Lance Allworth wide to the right. Mike Ditka, the tip tight end. Flip formation to the right side, but now Allworth in motion across the near side of the field. Handoffs on a straight ahead inside dive play to Garrison. And Walt with a second and a third effort, too, goes for about 3 yards, dragging both Spiderhar and Dick Butkus Garrison along. Tremendous second and third effort by the Cowboy, Walt Garrison. So it'll be second and 7 for the Cowboys on their own 23-yard line. And in comes Ernie Stoutner, the 6'2", 230-pounder of Boston College and the Pittsburgh Steelers. Not only a Hall of Famer elected in 1970, but also one of the Cowboy regular coaching staff, who's on one-time leave for just this game as a member of the all-time All-Stars. So how about that? A Cowboy coach for the All-Stars playing. Stoutner in there for Gino Marchetti at left end, or at defensive right end for the Stars. Art Donovan also in, now spelling Leo Normalini, who's been a tower of strength for the All-Stars at left tackle. So the star front four is Stoutner, Stidahar, Donovan, and Carl Eller. Here's Morton with his men on the firing line. Second and 7 on the 23. Cowboys trailing 7-3, and Bobby Hayes comes wide to the right side. Lance Allworth flanked wide to the left. Gene Fugit, the tight end, is split off to the left. There's Morton on the handoff to Calvin Hill, who starts wide to the left, makes his cut. Stoutner completely missed a tackle, and Stoutner just seemed to fall down, and Hill is finally knocked down 6 yards further up by big Ray Nitschke of the Green Bay Packers, the right linebacker of the Stars. A big 6 yards for the Cowboys, right over their coach, Ernie Stoutner, who missed a key tackle to give Hill a 6-yard gain to the Cowboy 29, third and 1 to go. And here comes Stoutner out of there as Lombardi and Rockne pull him after only one play. And right back in goes Gino Marchetti at right defensive end. And also in comes Willie Lanier of Morgan State and the Chiefs to give Kai Aldrich a rest at left linebacker. And now you've got the Cowboys spilling from that huddle and back onto the line with third and 1 and 3 minutes 10 seconds left in this first quarter. That ball's on the 29-yard Cowboy line, and flip formation to the right side. Bobby Hayes, the outside man, Lance Allworth, is now outside of him. And the handoff to Calvin Hill again as he cuts to his left on an inside play, and I don't think he made it, as he was stacked up by both Gino Marchetti and Joe Stidahar, aided by middle linebacker Dick Butkus. And there's a tremendous pile. He didn't make it, and the crowd likes that, and the Cowboys face a probable punting situation with 4th and 1 to go from the Cowboy 29 as that big Soldier Field clock ticks away to 3 minutes. And as it does, the temperature continues to fall steadily, now down still another degree. Piercing atmosphere at 29 in Soldier Field. Steely gray afternoon, but no rain, and the field still fast and in excellent condition, I think. The Cowboys will have to kick on 4th and 1, and they've got Marv Bateman. Line of scrimmage, the Cowboy 29, but Bateman way back there. Downfield, the All-Stars have a double safety with Red Grange and George Kipp of Notre Dame in for the reception. Both standing around the All-Star 30-yard line. And here's Bateman booting that ball, rather wobbly kick, that hits on the All-Star 40, gets Cowboy English, bounces the All-Star 22-yard line where George Kipp fields that ball, starts to right, crisscrosses with Grange, hands that ball off, Kipp does to Red Grange at the 20, Grange to the 25, cuts the far sidelines, the 30, the 35, Grange to the 40, he's got five blockers. Grange gets away from Dave Edwards at midfield. Good block by Hirsch at the 45. The 40, the 35. Grange somehow shouldered out of bounds at the Cowboy 33-yard line.
With Hirsch to Red Grange, he's out of bounds at
great
the Cowboy 33.
Sensational return by Grange. 38-yard return, and how Grange carried that ball. The galloping ghost. Just as sensational here today as in his headlines. On a little seam maneuver in pro football, Gipp took that kick reception and in a safety crisscross gave it to Grange, who began that long and electrifying gallop, saved only by free safety Charlie Waters, who's in there for Cliff Harris. And that gives All-Stars a first down, a Pope's 33-yard line. And here now, the Stars are going to go back to it. Standard strong right pro formation with Johnny Unitas in there now. First time for Sammy Baugh at quarter. And the running backs, Bronco Nagurski at full and Red Grange at half, with George Kipp having replaced Jim Thorpe at the flanker spot wide of the right. Here goes Kipp in motion to the left. As Unitas takes that ball back 3 steps, on the draw play, feeds it to Big Nagurski, who bulldozes his way forward for 4, 5, 6 yards to the Cowboy 27-yard line. Which will bring up a 2nd and 4 for the All-Stars at the Cowboy 27. This Nagurski, who bombed down the middle 9 yards for the Star score a while ago, is astonishing to watch. Pure brute power. And don't forget on KNUS the great features you're getting throughout the regular broadcast day. The Ken Dow and Granny Emma Show each morning, America's favorite morning team. The KNUS flagpole sitter, Jim Dean, who on January 23rd, if he stays up there, will have broken the world's record flagpole sitting for 248 days. And the Academy Award-winning Dorothy Malone, who's now our KNUS newscaster. The controversial Rod Roddy, now on KNUS, where all the stars are. And coming next year on America's most talked-about FM station, the world's largest Christmas tree. You'll see it in Dallas, over 150 feet high. And the All-Star offensive line with 2nd and 4 to go for the All-Stars on the Cowboy 27-yard line. All-Stars lead it 7-3. The line reads this way, left to right. Don Hutson of Alabama's Crimson Tide, who's in there for Elroy Hirsch. Another great receiver, Hutson. Remember him with Dixie Howell of Alabama and then at Green Bay? Hutson, George Connor, Jim Parker, Bulldog Turner back in for Mel Hine, Gene Hickerson at right guard, Forrest Gregg at right tackle, and John Mackey at right end. Here's Johnny Unitas barking those signals. Pitch out to the flanker, George Kipp. Gets away from Kipp back of the line, and George has to dive on it to save that ball. Back at the Cowboy 32, a loss of 5. It was an easy underhand pitch out from Unitas, but Kipp was so anxious to be off with it that he simply ran out from under the ball and was lucky to get back at all in time to recover it. That makes it 3rd and 9 for the All-Stars from the 32. A 5-yard loss, and you've got 1.5 minutes in the first quarter yet to play. The Cowboy 32-yard line. 1.25 minutes, let's see, 1.5 minutes on the scoreboard yet to play. Again, Johnny Unitas subbing for Sammy Baugh at the moment at quarter. Positions his Cardinal clad All-Stars on the front line. The Cowboys with their regular front four back in, Toomey, Lilly, Pugh, and Smith. And the starting linebackers, right to left, Chuck Howley, Leroy Jordan, and Dave Edwards. No, D.D. Lewis is in there for Edwards, I see. And here are the Stars on the line, 3rd and 9, the Cowboy 32. Unitas, quick count, fades the throw, gets a good protection from Lilly and Pugh. They can't get to him. He's got George Kipp on the sidelines. There's a pass complete to Kipp, who's hit immediately on the Cowboy 19 by Mel Renfro. Beautiful catch by Kipp. Howley never had a chance since that sideline pass. is the most difficult of all to defend against. Kip ran a down-and-out pattern, good for 13 yards, the down-and-out. That completion from Unitas to the Cowboy 19, and good, of course, also for an all-star first down, with George Kip having stepped out of bounds to stop the clock with a minute and 20 seconds left of the first quarter. As we have an official's timeout on the field, and in comes time for KNUS.
Rod Roddy here. Looking back over the years, we screamed at each other on the telephone, over hotline. Those hostile moments are gone forever. But I'm alive and well inside KNews Information, still pumping out the truth in staggering doses, much to the dismay of all too many fog-bound individuals. Join me here weekdays as I continue to take verbal pot shots at well-known bigots and famous Big D bumblers of our time. And never fear, I promise not to neglect the national nitwits either. You may have your own word for what I do, but it is, without a doubt, the strongest brand of news commentary on the air today. Remember, Rod Roddy, my column, inside KNews Information.
KNUS, Dallas.
Unitas in there for Sammy Baugh, and speaking of Sammy Baugh, always reminds us of the old Ray Flaherty story when Baugh played his 15 seasons for the Washington Redskins. One time when he was a rookie, Flaherty called him in and he said, "Now, Baugh, see that receiver right there pointing to one of the Washington ends? I want you to hit him right in the eye." And Baugh looked at Flaherty and he said, "Which eye?" The All-Stars quickly back to it, and here's the shotgun formation again, the old short punt, with Unitas calling those signals on first down from the Cowboy 19. He's got George Giff in motion, the wide receiver Don Hutson far to the left. Unitas fades with it, back to the 30, the pass, intended for Hutson, intercepted down the 4-yard line on a deep down and in pattern, picked off by Waters at the 4, Waters the far side under the 10, the 15, the 20 gets blocking, cuts back infield to the 30, the 35, the 40, the 45, knocked out of bounds in All-Star territory at the 49-yard line.
Unitas pass.
Brilliant interception, and even more brilliant run back by Charlie Waters, who got two bone-shaking blocks by Mel Renfro and Pat Toomey. As Waters brought that ball back, and yes, Tony Smith had a good block in there too. So the complexion changes again at Soldiers Field. A turnover just as the All-Stars were knocking at that Cowboy goal line. And now suddenly it's the Cowboys in star territory at the All-Star 49. A moment ago it was Unitas at the Cowboy 99, but Waters intercepted him, brought it back beautifully. Courtesy, Charlie Waters, and lots of blockers, and 1 minute left in the first quarter as the Cowboys come on that line with first and 10 to go for the All-Star 49. The Stars set up a front four of Marchetti, Steidahar, Nomalini, Leo Nomalini, and Carl Eller, the linebackers Chuck Bednarik, Dick Butkus, and Kai Aldrich is back in there. Warren Lahr of the Cleveland Browns for Emlyn Tunnell at left cornerback. Morton sets his eyes spread, gets that ball, starts fading for a first down forward. He's got turn, the pocket holds, Morton pumps twice, three turns, throws that ball. Long one, a fly pattern, deep downfield, Hayes flicked away, incomplete at the last moment, as Hayes went down in a fruitless tangle with Larry Wilson of the Cardinals and All-Stars. So that ball is going to come back to the All-Star 49-yard line. Second down and 10 yards to go, with 45 seconds remaining of this initial quarter in a near pandemonium among the crowd. That's the excitement. And again on that line, which could be the final play of the first quarter, are the Cowboys. Second and 10 on the All-Star 49-yard line after a 47-yard run with an intercepted pass by linebacker Charlie Waters. The clock has started to run as those Cowboys set the eye flip formation, split in the backfield now with Bobby Newhouse, who's in to give Hill a rest. And Walt Garrison now, Hayes is wide to the left. Trap play up the middle as Garrison lugs that ball 3, 4, 5, 6 yards. Sensational second and again a third effort by Garrison as he pulled Carl Eller and Kai Aldrich along with him. And it took Dick Butkus finally to finish off Garrison. But a 6-yard Garrison finish it was to the play and to the first quarter with the Cowboys third down and 4 yards to go at the All-Star 43-yard line. And as the first quarter concludes, the All-Stars lead 7-3. These teams begin to change sides, and we'll be back after this from KNUS.
The Godfather is now a movie. one of the most brutal and moving chronicles of American life ever designed within the limits of popular entertainment, raised the New York Times. Gene Shalit, NBC TV, calls it one of the finest gangster movies ever made. Newsweek says there is only one Brando. He is the Godfather, the centerpiece of what promises to be the Gone with the Wind of gangster movies. The Godfather, from Paramount, rated R, under 17, not admitted without parent.
Now showing at Mclendon's Capri, Astro, Gemini, Plano, Century, Chateau, Park Plaza, Apollo, and the Bruton Road.
KNUS, Dallas.
Back to football, Soldiers Field in Chicago. The old Scotsman Gordon Mclendon before, what, 110,000 scalper seats at $500 apiece for the better ones. Exclusively this game to you play-by-play on KNUS, the home of Ken Thau and Granny Emma every weekday morning. America's finest morning team. KNUS, the new home of Dorothy Malone, Academy Award winner, now on the KNUS News team, and the new home of Rod Roddy. KNUS, the big winner in Dallas radio, America's most talked about FM station. The Cowboys will now be moving from our right to our left. The All-Stars, of course, from the left to the right, as you view it from the press box and the broadcasting booths. And the second quarter getting underway. Cowboys ball, as you hear the loudspeaking system tell you, third and fourth from the All-Star 43. Stars lead 7-3. Cowboys set the eye with Craig Morton sending Ron Sellers, who's back in for Hayes, wide to the left, and Lance Allworth is in motion. The snap to Morton. The blitz is on as Morton backpedals the throw, but his pocket caves in as Dick Butkus and Gino Marchetti both caught the gap. Morton's down there, sacked for a 9-yard loss. Back to the Cowboy 48-yard line. Tremendous blitz by Butkus and Marchetti. And Kai Aldrich was in there, too, for final help with the tackle. Great TCU star of yesteryear, Kai Aldrich. So when play comes in now and the Cowboys go back into their huddle, it'll be 4th and 13 for the Cowboys. Think of the great quarterbacks who didn't even make the taxi squad today. Think of them. Sid Luckman, Otto Graham, Norm Van Brocklin, Johnny Lujack, Charlie Trippi of Georgia, Bobby Lane of Texas, just to mention a few who didn't even make the taxi squad. And the Cowboys now have that ball, 4th and 13 at their own 48-yard line. The field goal unit is in. Danny Reeves to hold, and Tony Fritsch will try a very long 59-yard field goal. Line of scrimmage at the Cowboy 48, but they count seven more as the All-Stars set up a 9-man line to try to block it. All-Stars lead 7-3, so now the All-Stars have Red Grange and George Gipp deep around the goal line just in case. And here's Fritsch to try that 59-yarder. As Reeves puts it down, it is no good, and sure enough, short. Again taken by Grange at the Cowboy 3, the 5, the 10, the 15. Red Grange to the 20, cuts the center of the field, sidesteps Howley. Nearly free at the 25, Grange at the 30, got a block at the 35, over the 40, the 45, knocked out of bounds by Lance Allworth on the 46-yard All-Star line. Sparkling 43-yard run back of Tony Fritsch's short field goal attempt by Red Grange of the Illini and Chicago Bears. And Grange continues to show here why that number 77 is canonized in Illinois. A short field goal attempt on a 59-yard try. Cowboys might have felt that it was as good as a kick, but it fell short, and that's the danger with a short field goal, the danger of a run back, and Red Grange made the danger a very real one. He must have slipped three tackles on the way. Got a vital block from Kai Aldrich and looked like the proverbial whirling dervish. So the All-Stars go back to the fray with a new series of downs, starting from their own 46-yard line. The strong side right as Unitas has a backfield again of Jim Thorpe in there for Nagurski. Red Grange at half, and Jim Thorpe is back in at flanker back, we told you. Unitas takes it. The give is to Jim Brown on the draw play right up the tunnel. And Brown drives for 3-4 yards to midfield before he's dropped there by Lilly, Pugh, and Jordan. And it took all three of those tremendous players to finally immobilize Jim Brown. 4-yard gain, and that ball squarely on the 50-yard line, which will bring up an All-Star 2nd and 6 as the Stars lead at Soldiers Field 7-3 after three plays of this, the second quarter. And the atmosphere seems to grow chiller still. Although the temperature has not yet gone down farther, still 29, but this huge crowd huddled in overcoats is nonetheless burning with excitement at this once-in-a-lifetime gridiron spectacle. Here you've got the Stars on the line at midfield, second and sixth for the All-Stars. And now the Stars show the Cowboys the eye. Stars playing the eye with Unitas heading up that vertical line of back. Speedy, Grange, and Brown. Speedy now in motion to the right as Unitas takes that ball. Thought he was going to bootleg it, but he feeds it to Grange, who's going to be hit behind the line, and is. That looked like a busted play for the All-Stars, and I think it was. Grange overwhelmed by Lily and Toomey at the All-Star 47 for a loss of three, third and nine, as someone obfuscated the play, and that's the first time today that Red Grange has been thrown for loss. And at halftime, the Cowboy coaches, particularly Tom Landry, to comment on the first half action, and Roger Staubach, who will see action in the second half, will be at the KNUS microphone, along with Craig Morton, who's playing here in the first half. So you'll get the Cowboy reaction to the first half at halftime on KNUS. Don't move the dial. The old Scotsman, Gordon Mclendon, Soldiers Field, Chicago. 2 minutes gone of the second quarter. All-Stars lead the Cowboys 7-3 before 110,000. The Stars in their shining scarlet jerseys on that line, third and nine. 2 minutes gone of the second quarter. The Stars set up this time their fourth different offensive formation, triple wing in the passing situation. With Unitas close, Jim Brown back into his left off the offensive left guard. Grange inside the tight end on the right, and Jim Thorpe flanked farther out. Off the triple, Unitas has it, fades 8-10 steps to throw. He's got protection, going to go for his wide receiver. Don Hudson on the far sideline, can't get him. As this time, Mel Renfro is able to contest for that football successfully. On the sideline pass, and knock it out of bounds. Down around the Calpo 35, where Renfro broke it up, which will bring up a fourth and kicking situation of 9 to go for the Stars with the ball at their own 47. That time, the Stars showed us the triple wing, the fourth offensive alignment they've gone with today. First was the standard pro strong right, then the shotgun, which is the old short punt. Third was Rockne's Notre Dame box, and then just now in the passing situation, they set up a triple wing. Great formation when you've got a passer like Unitas or Ball in that backfield who can throw an option pass. Fourth and nine for the All-Stars on their own 47. Sammy back into the game. Comes Sammy Ball to replace Johnny Unitas, and he'll do the All-Star kicking. Ball, finest kicker of his era. Once kicked 14 times against Louisiana State for a 48-yard average. And kicked out of bounds seven times, yes, within the LSU 5-yard line. Ball boot from around the 36, line of scrimmage at the 49. Here's the kick, a beauty. Sammy, like the old days, trying for Coffin Corner, and Hayes Renfro at the ball bounce. It bounced. It kicks out of bounds at the 1-yard line. 52-yard Coffin Corner kick by Sammy Ball. Actually about 63 yards in the air. That goes out of bounds on the 1-yard line. Puts the Cowboys deep in a gopher hole. And now the Cowboys, back in their huddle in the end zone, will have it with a first down from their 1-yard line, trailing 7-3 in the second quarter. Morton feeds Calvin Hill on a slant play at the left side, and Neely and Nyland clear the way from him, scoring to about the old 5-yard line as it's unpiled, with about six All-Stars in on the pile. And Kai Aldrich, the last one off. Hill, with that lumbering power, simply ramming his way up to the 5 for 4 yards to set up a second, and Cowboys 6 to go. And so the All-Stars have their Sunday best on that line defensively. Gino Marchetti, Joe Steidehar, Leo Nomolini, and Carl Eller, and the linebackers Chuck Bednarik, Dick Butkus, and Willie Lemire has just come in for Kai Aldrich, as Morton has a backfield in the eye of Fugit. Walt Garrison and Calvin Hill back in there, with Billy Parks also back in at flanker, and Sellers for Bob Hayes at wide receiver. Parks is sent in motion again, right to left, as Morton calls those signals, fakes to Garrison, gives to Hill again, draw play up the middle. Calvin to the 9, 10 up to the 12-yard line for a first down that gives the Cowboys a little breathing room after Sammy Ball had Coffin Corner kicked them out of bounds on the 1-yard line. Now they're back to their own 12. First down, 8 plays deep into the second quarter as the officials take time out on the field, and we'll choose the moment to take time out for KNUS.
Since early May, Jim Dean has been spending 24 hours a day on the KNews flagpole at the Gemini Theater on North Central. If he stays for over 248 days, 9 hours, he'll break the world's flagpole sitting record and score $5,000. If you can tell us exactly how long he will stay, you and a friend will score a beautiful, all-expense-paid week for two at the Las Brisas in Acapulco. Send or bring us a card today. KNUS, 1917 Elm, Dallas.
KNUS, Dallas.
Soldiers Field in Chicago, sodden skies above, but no forecast for rain, a small but marrow-chilling breeze penetrating the stadium crowd with the thermometer at 28 down, still another degree. 5 degrees it's gone down since this game started. Morton now on the line, calls those signals. Craig jabs that ball to Walt. Garrison starts to the left, cuts outside beyond Rayfield, right, who has Ella blocked in, and Walt to the 15, 16, 17-yard line. Willie Lanier coming up for a solid shot there. And Garrison gives the Pokes 5 more to set up a 2nd and 5 at the 17 in the Cowboys' own bailiwick. Cowboys sticking to the ground deep in their own danger zone at the Cowboys 17. Now in the All-Star line, as Lombardi and Rockne substitute copiously, you've got Ray Nitschke at left linebacker for Chuck Bednarik, and Kai Aldrich back in there for Willie Lanier on the right linebacking post. Willie Wood of the Green Bay Packers has taken over for Jack Christensen, that strong safety. Larry Wilson of the Cards has played all the way so far. Morton in the eye at the 17, 2nd and 5. And Morton's got Parks and Sellers split to the right side. Now here comes Parks in motion to the near side of the field. Hill and Garrison running back. Goes to Walt Garrison on a dead-ahead plunge, and whatever hole there was vanished instantaneously. As Garrison arrived, the hole clogged up. No gain, I think, on the play, and there isn't. 3rd and 5 for the Cowboys from their 17. And give that tackle to the whole front four of the Stars. Marchetti, Steidahar, Nomalini, and Eller. As Hill went down in an immense pile. This exclusively to you on KNUS Soldiers Field in Chicago. At halftime, the Cowboy coaches, including Tom Landry and Craig Morton and Roger Staubach, all will comment on the first half. 11th play of this, the second quarter, coming up, and the Cowboys playing catch-up. 7-3 behind they are. And it's worth mentioning that that first-string Cowboy offensive line of Sellers, Neely, Nyland, Manders, Blaine Nye, and Rayfield Wright has been superb this afternoon. You can certainly forgive the one time they became a bit porous on that 9-yard touchdown burst by the incomparable Bronco Nagurski. Understandable. Morton close over Manders, 3rd and 5, split in the backfield. Hill at the right side, Garrison to the left. Morton will keep it and try to throw as Hill on a down and in pattern sees that ball deflected as Morton tried to rifle it in there about the 22. And it's incomplete. Back it goes. 4th down and 5, the Cowboys 17, which could set up highly favorable field situation for the All-Stars. And the Cowboy kicking team comes on that field. Exclusively to you, KNUS brings it. Play-by-play, Cowboys and the all-time All-Stars. KNUS, home of Dorothy Malone now, Rod Roddy, home of Ken Dow and Granny Emma. Home next year of the world's largest Christmas tree, over 150 feet high, ought to be a nationwide attraction. KNUS, the most talked about FM station in America today. And the Cowboys now presented with a potentially perilous kicking situation as Marv Bateman will have to stand back there around the 3-yard line to kick that ball. The line of scrimmage on the Cowboys 17, obviously a 4th down. The All-Stars upfield around their own 45 have this twin safeties, Doak Walker, who's in there for George Gipp, and Red Grange. Bateman awaiting the snap from Manders. There it is. He boots that ball spiraling in very high. It's over the midfield line. Doak Walker, number 37, signaling for a fair catch, and he has it at the 45-yard All-Star line as Marv Bateman pumps out what will be a 38-yard kick from the Cowboy line of scrimmage. Thusly, the Cardinal jerseyed All-Stars will have it 1st and 10 from their own 45 in what was and is forecastably fortuitous field position. Balls back in there for Unitas. Jim Thorpe for Doak Walker. And Ball have Jim Brown and Red Grange as the two running backs. And, of course, a third, Thorpe, as a flanker. And now, an official's timeout as we hear again from KNUS.
Hi, this is Bart Mclendon reminding you to stay tuned during halftime as I visit the Cowboy locker room. Among others, I'll be talking to quarterbacks Craig Morton and Roger Staubach, as well as Coach Tom Landry. That's at halftime today.
KNUS, Dallas.
Back to Soldiers Field in Chicago, and when play is resumed, that clock will tick away with 3 minutes 40 seconds gone in the second quarter of this savagely played struggle at Soldiers Field. Football's all-time all-stars leading the Dallas Cowboys 7-3 on Bronco Nagurski's 9-yard burst with a stop after a 9-yard gain by Jim Brown, who got a good block on Chuck Howley by the wide receiver Crazy Legs Hurst. And so the 110,000 plus here at Soldiers Field in Chicago, decked out in a panoply of color, continue their roaring as the All-Stars move to a second and two on the Dallas 48. The weather crisp and chill, the field dry. Nearly perfect football day as the All-Stars lead 7-3. Here's that All-Star team again, second and two, being led out of the huddle by Big Mel Hine, the All-American of Washington State, who played 15 years for the New York Giants, 230-pound center. Ball goes into the crouch at quarter, looks from one side to the other, starts to call those signals. Takes a snap, he's going to go with Jim Brown again. Brown threw that for the first down over the Cowboys, 45-yard line down to the 43. With Jethro Pugh coming up off the ground to trip Jim Brown behind. And again, it took two Cowboys to make that tackle secure, with both Cornell Green, the strong side safety, and Leroy Jordan helping Pugh put the copper rivets on the lunging Jim Brown, who had shaken off Bob Lilly as he went through there for the first down. The All-Stars' eighth first down of the game. And with 9 minutes left in the second quarter, you've got the All-Stars in those brilliant red shirts. First and four new ones to go from the Cowboy 43. On the far sidelines, the two All-Star co-head coaches, Vince Lombardi and Newt Rockne, are joined for a word by Howard Jones, the great former coach at head coach at UFC, and Bud Wilkinson. All four of them in a little huddle. Now here is the all-time All-American Big Bronco Nagurski of the Chicago Bears racing in to replace Jim Brown at fullback. Danny Fortman of the Bears comes in to replace Gene Hickerson at right guard. And again, Don Hutson, the great All-American from Alabama, will go in there at wide receiver as Hurst comes off. The All-Stars are going to break that huddle with Ball leading that team up to the line. Sammy calls those signals again. You've got Jim Thorpe in motion from his flanker position. Moving now right to left. And Ball begins to fade. 9, 10, 12 steps. It's going to be a screen and is as Ball tosses that ball just in front of Nagurski, who's got four man blocking as he goes to the right. The Cowboys can't get to him. Nagurski hit by Howley and Mel Renfro around the 38-yard line. Lateraling suddenly to Red Grange. Gets away from Charlie Waters. Sidesteps Cornell Green to 25. Goes from 20 on the far sideline. Grange finally knocked out of bounds on the Cowboy 11-yard line. Knocked out of bounds by the last man who had a chance at him at all. Free safety Cliff Harris playing a great game. And Cliff finally got him on a touchdown saving tackle as that play covered 32 yards. First on a ball on the Gersky screen pass. And then around the 38, when Howley and Mel Renfro both hit big Nagurski, Bronco was still able to get away a last second lateral flip to Grange, who moved down that sideline like a green deal going down a slippery drain pipe. He got away from Cornell Green, and it looked for a moment as though Red might go all the way, but in the last instant, Cliff Harris shoulder blocked him out of bounds, and listen to the crowd just continuing to roar. Ball had Jim Thorpe in the clear, but the call was for the screen pass, and Sam stayed with it to Nagurski. So back to the All-Stars, knocking it in the Cowboy goal line on the power of Nagurski, the elusiveness of Grange, who took that lateral. Grange already has over 40 yards today. It's still relatively early in the second quarter, 8.5 minutes still to go. All-Stars on the line. Cowboys now in what is almost a nine-man line. Ball holds up his hands for quiet, takes a moment waiting for that crowd to calm down a bit. A group of youngsters across the way holding a huge banner aloft. Get 'em, Grange, naturally. Red, ever popular here in his native Illinois. The big Soldier Steel crowd really rocking these rafters. Ball yells out his huts on the line as Thorpe is in motion, and Sammy's going to throw. Complete to Don Hutson, very close to the Cowboy goal line. The great receiver, the Red Elephant of Alabama, and let's see if Hutson got in there before Cornell Green stopped him. Coming all the way over from the strong side to make the tackle, and no, he didn't. Hutson down on the Cowboy one-yard line. About a yard and a half, actually. Not quite enough for the first down. So the All-Stars will add it second and about a half yard to go. Crowd ready for the saliva test. About a half yard to go for the first down. A Cowboy 1.5 yard line. Ball has a backfield of Red Grange, Bronco Nagurski, and Jim Thorpe. But now, coaches Lombardi and Rockney are taking out both Grange and Thorpe. In for Grange comes the battering ram, enormous Marion Motley of the Cleveland Browns. And Jim Brown comes in to replace Thorpe. So the All-Stars up to send in their maximum power, and they've now got three of the game's greatest and most savage running backs in the game at the same time behind ball. Bronco Nagurski, Jim Brown, and Motley. And so, who do you key on to try to stop the rush in that backfield? Out go Grange and Thorpe. In come Motley and Jim Brown, and the pressure on. The Cowboy defense will have to be unbelievable now. Any of Baugh's three running backs are specialists at taking it in there. And Sammy Baugh is nobody's amateur at the keeper play himself. Baugh brings his red-shirted All-Stars forward, starts to call those signals. This time it's Jim Brown in motion. Baugh's going to go with Motley right into the middle of an enormous traffic jam around the goal line. All of the Cowboys front four, Toomey, Lilly, Pugh, and Smith all in there. So are Leroy Jordan and Chuck Howley on the pile. And let's see, Motley did not make it. And it's 1 foot short, but that's still enough for an All-Star first down, first and goal to go, as the elephant behind Marion Motley, the 240-pound Cleveland Brown, slashed his way into the center of the Cowboy line for a single hard 1 yard and a first down with goal to go. All-Stars lead 7-3 with 7 minutes and 15 seconds left in the second quarter, and the Stars knocking at that Cowboy goal line insistently. With first and goal, there's an official timeout for the moment on the playing field as the bands continue to play. And the banners wave, and both teams relax for a moment before resuming play. And here's KNUS.
Hi there, this is Ken Dow of the Ken and Granny Show. And this is my grandmother, who's a part of the team, 7 to 10 mornings on KNUS.
That's right. I'm one of Gordon's gals. There's Dorothy Malone and me and Susan Stafford.
Just a second. That's all well and good, but we are supposed to be doing this promotion for our show, 7 to 10 o'clock morning. See, grandmother?
No, I don't see you, you chauvinistic male pig. This is a women's liver promotional announcement. There's Dorothy Malone, inside K-News information ever out. There's the lovely Susan Stafford, who's on every Sunday morning with interesting 30-minute interviews with people like the wonderful Richard Harris of MacArthur Park fame, the beautiful Mitzi Gaynor, and, of course, Roger Staubach, talking to interesting people like that. Susan, who is so beautiful that every time I see her, I say, Susan, put a sack over your head. I'm the jealous type, you see.
KNUS, Dallas.
The old Scotsman, Gordon Mclendon, Soldiers Field, alive with attention. By itself, the All-Star Taxi Squad alone would strike fear into the hearts of any football team, professional or college, with players like Gale Sayers, Alan Page, Dave Robinson, George McAfee, Ace Parker, Paul Warfield on that taxi squad. But here it is, time in again, and the Cowboys again erect what is tantamount to a nine-man defensive forward wall, with the twin safeties, Cliff Harris and Cornell Green, close behind. Cornerbacks maybe a step behind the line itself, spread out as a just-in-case pass defense in the unlikely event that Sammy Baugh decides to cross everyone up and throw that ball. First down for the All-Stars, and 1 foot, they lead 7-3, second quarter. Signals by Baugh. He gives it to Jim Brown, who's hit immediately by Lilly somewhere around the line of scrimmage, and again, there's an enormous pileup. Tody Smith, Dave Edwards, Charlie Waters, all in there to help Lilly as Jim Brown tried to knife his way over the right side of his own line, and there was no hole at all. The irresistible force meeting several immovable objects. And he didn't make it, Jim Brown. The ball is being put down on the 6-inch line. Second down and still goal to go for the All-Stars. And the Cowboys will be grabbing for that ball, trying to take it away. Neither Hickerson nor George Connor was able to open a hole for Jim Brown that time. Now let's see what ball do as the Stars break that huddle again and come toward the line. Man, this is a real split-sided spam slice pea picker here in Chicago today. Ball has his men on the line. The signals as Brown goes in motion, but the handoff is to Bronco Nagurski on a dive play at the left side of the line this time, and again, there is no immediate indication as to whether he made it or not. The Cowboys' doomsday defense beginning to look more like its old self. The officials untangling that pile.
Pat Toomey, Lily, Jethro Pugh, Howley, all underneath the pile, intertwined with Big McGurski, and he did not make it. No gain on the play, and that ball stays squarely where it was on the 6-inch line, where it'll be third and two for the All-Stars, who had it first down at the 11, then second down at the 1.5, then first down at the 1.5-yard line, and second at the 6-inch line. And now it's third down at the 6-inch as Ball huddles his men, and let's see which way Sling and Sam will have them going on the third down play. There it is, all-timer Mel Hine over that ball, and Ball directly behind him with a backfield of Nagurski, Marion Motley, and Jim Brown. Ball begins to bark those signals as the crowd continues at pandemonium. Ball's standard, pull, strong side right. What's he going to do here on 36 inches? Signals, long call. Nobody in motion. Ball gives Jim Brown, starts wide of the left, bereft of blocking, and there's Chuck Howley through there with a savage waist-high shot at Jim Brown behind the line. A loss back to the four-yard line. All-star loss of three as Howley had the perfect prescience of that play and came roaring through to smash Jim Brown, who had set sail around his own left side. Brown got one block from George Connor of Notre Dame, and that was all. And then in spilled Howley over the defense beautifully to force the All-Stars into a fourth and four to go from their own four-yard line from the Cowboy four. Cowboys trailing the Stars 7-3, threatening again, but the Cowboys putting up a refrangent goal line stand. And so it's that do-or-die fourth and goal from the four for the All-Stars, who've got Nagurski and Brown at running backs. Thorpe set wide at flanker, and we'll know in a moment what Sammy Baugh is going to do. Baugh, incidentally, is calling his own plays, none coming in from the sidelines. Sling and Sam being a veteran of 15 years pro play on his own. Obviously, Lombardi and Rockney allowing him latitude. They send in suggestions, but the final decisions are Sam's own. He has those All-Stars on the battle line now. They're going to go from the pro strong side right, and this time he does send Thorpe in sliding motion left off to the left. Long count by Ball. The ball is Sam. He's going to throw to the end zone. He's got Thorpe in the corner, throws, and Charlie Waters goes high with Indian Jim, and that ball's intercepted by Charlie Waters in the end zone. As he wins a mid-air struggle for the ball with Thorpe, and the Cowboys have held magnificently on a series of downs that began at the Cowboy 1.5. Unbelievable defensive Cowboy stand as they take over on the Polk 4, first and 10, with 7 minutes left of this second quarter. And Charlie Waters' in-zone interception could be the great turning point of the ball game. He out-wrestles Thorpe in mid-air. The Cowboys now will have that, what do they call it, prolate spheroid, the football at the 20. And even with Nagurski and Brown both in there, and Motley too, all three of them, the All-Stars couldn't smash it over. Savage Cowboy defense with murderous infighting in those forward walls at the goal line. Cowboys at the 20 now have Morton over Manders. Staubach will go in the second half. Morton yelling the signals in the ice-cold afternoon air. Stridently, Craig's handoff to Calvin Hill, who starts to the right. Now a handoff to Walt Garris, going to the right on a daring reverse along the goal line. And Garris through with a fine block by Neely, another by Manders, 25, 29, 30, 32-yard line. On a reverse from Morton to Hill to Garrison. 12-yard gain. That saw right cornerback Dick Lane, Mike Crane Lane, come up to make the stop after Dino Marchetti and Chuck Bednarik. Both had hands on Garrison but couldn't hold him as Rydham Waltz went for 12 Cowboy yards and a first down. The clock continuing to tick away, second quarter seconds with 6.5 minutes left to go. And Landry sends in young Fugit with his play action to come. Game amazingly free of injuries, but marred in its early stages by penalties against both teams. Now Morton has them up there in their three-point stances on the line. First and 10, Cowboys at the 32. They're behind 7-3 as the Stars just failed at the Cowboy goal line. Had four tries at it. Morton with Parks in motion on the halfback option. Gives to Walt Garrison for the second time in a row, and Walt has a short gain of about two, exactly two, trying to move over Blaine Nye, and Rayfield's right on the right side. Garrison's plunge, setting up a second, and Cowboy eight to go. As the All-Stars go into a defensive huddle, back toward the northern goal to our left, Soldiers Field, Chicago. Excitement, unbelievable. You could cut it with a knife. Second and Cowpoke eight with Morton at the rudder. Cowboys came back from the brink a moment ago as Charlie Waters took a pass away from Jim Thorpe in midair in the end zone for a touchback that saved a touchdown. And Morton has his Cowboys at the line. Flip formation with Sellers far to the left, the wide receiver. With Morton giving the Calvin Hill on the left side full length for just short ground, maybe 2-3 yards. It's three as they unfile Spiderhar and Marchetti off-hill at the Cowboy 37-yard line. Third and 5 to go as the Stars still lead, 7-3. Another sign across the field which reads, go Grange, go Butkus, go Spiderhar. All three great favorites in Chicago. Among other great Illinois native stars in the All-Star roster this afternoon. Still another sign, a great one. A day away from Howard Cosell is like a month in the country, it says. They're really giving Cosell fits with the signs in Chicago this afternoon. Morton with 3rd and 5 from the Cowboy 37 as they've come in 3 plays from the 20. Craig's got Billy Parks coming wide to the left. Sellers wide to the right. Garrison Hill, the running back. Setback. Passing situation. That's what it's going to be as Morton fades the throw. Skim pass knocked away from Walt Garrison. 14 yards upfield at 49 as Emlyn Tonnell was completely on top of that skim pass pattern. Evidently on the skim. The Cowboys had seen Dick Butkus, the middle linebacker, moving too far right and set Walt Garrison skipping through there between Sellers and Neely. And they were right. Butkus wasn't there, but Emlyn Tonnell was. And it'll become 4th and still 5 to go to bring up a kicking down with Marv Bateman and his specialist team in there to get rid of that football. The Stars substituting Gip for Thorpe. And Grange is also in there. The Cowboys now have it in a kicking necessity with Bateman quite deep around his own 22. Line of scrimmage on the Cowboy 37 as the Stars have Red Grange and George Gip deep around the All-Star 20. Bateman gets it away, and this is a phenomenal kick. Chasing Grange and Gip back to the 10. The 8-yard line where George Gip takes it back to the 10. The 15, he's out to the 20. Gipper cuts to the center of the field, the 25, the 30. Gets 2 blocks at the 35, into the 40 down the near sidelines, and the clear at the 50, the 45. Gip at the 40, the 35. George Gip is going all the way. Sensational yards on a return of Marv Bateman's 51-yard kick all the way for a touchdown. Gip, and George Gip has just showed why he was Notre Dame's first All-American player. Why Pudge Heffelfinger called him the most versatile back of all time. And George Gip may have proved, as they say, that he can run that 110-2 in a football uniform. Electrifying moment in the history of football, that. Lou Groza waiting. It's put down for him. Boots it, and it's 14-3. The All-Stars 14, the Cowboys 3, as the crowd just beginning to settle now, following George Gipps' amazing 92-yard run on the punt return. And there'll be 2.5 minutes left as the Cowboys and All-Stars spread to their respective positions. Bob Newhouse will be in there. And you've got the Cowboys spread deep around the goal line as Groza will boot that ball. It'll go very deep into the end zone. And Newhouse himself is going to take it and will down it about 5 yards deep in the end zone with 2.5 minutes left here of the first half. The Cowboys, when play is in, will have it first down and 10 yards to go on the 20-yard line. KNUS bringing it exclusively to you, Soldiers Field in Chicago. 2.5 minutes left to go. Morton brings his men forward, sets the forces up in the eye. Morton waiting, long count, gets it. Morton back, pumps. A swerving up pass, complete to Walt Garrison to the Cowboy 46-yard line. That's 20 yards, and Garrison hit immediately up there by Buckets and Aldridge, the linebackers, as if he were running a shorter swerve, and then Walt raced his defensive man, Night Train Lane, deep upfield and beat lane for a 26-yard gain. And that's going to mean the two-minute warning at Soldiers Field, and time for KNUS.
Rod Roddy here, and notwithstanding the fact that Christmas is almost upon us, I'm making a list and checking it twice. And with any luck, you won't be on it. That's right, I'm a troublemaker for jerks, creeps, and other social misfits who make life more difficult for everyone. And as long as I'm airworthy, I intend to keep at it. So join me here, weekdays, for my column, Inside KNews Information. And let me thrill your soul with the words of truth so seldom heard in public, especially here in Dallas. Remember, Rod Roddy, my column, Inside KNews Information.
KNUS, Dallas.
All Scotsman Gordon Mclendon, Soldiers Field, time will be in again in a moment in the two-minute warning. And at halftime, the Cowboy coaches, including Tom Landry, and also the quarterbacks, Craig Morton, who's played this first half, and Roger Staubach, who'll see action in the second, will be at the KNUS microphone. And the Cowboys will have it their own 46-yard line, first and 10, as Morton in the eye, calling those signals. Barks hustily in the killing air. Morton gets it, feeds his tight end, field it on an end around, and he gets 15 yards, but doesn't get out of bounds. As Night Train Lane comes up to put the rivets on him, Cowboys stopping that clock with 55 seconds left to go by calling their first timeout. Cowboys on the All-Star 49-yard line, striving to get in at least field goal trying position, if not in a position for something more fortuitous than that. It'll be with 55 seconds left to go. The Cowboys with 2nd and 3 on the All-Star 49-yard line. And we've reminded you on a couple of occasions of the great taxi squad that the All-Stars have. Absolutely fantastic. And the great coaching staff. Fielding Hurry Up Yost of Michigan, General Bob Nalen of Tennessee, the venerable Amos Alonzo Stagg of Chicago, Pop Warner of the Carlisle Indians and Temple. There's Matty Bell of Southern Methodist down there, Bud Wilkins from the Oklahoma Sooners, Clark Shaughnessy of Stanford and the Chicago Bears, Paul Brown of the Cleveland Browns and Cincinnati Bengals, and of course Jim Crowley of Fordham, one of Notre Dame's unforgettable four horsemen, Miller, Layden, Crowley, and Stoldreer, none of whom were nominated for the All-Star team, taxi or otherwise. All right, play is in with 55 seconds left, and the Cowboys 2nd and 3 on the All-Star 49-yard line. Cowboys striving to get forward for first position, field goal stick. Morton, in the eye, barking the signals, gets it, starts to fade. Tries a sideline pass to Sellers, but Night Train Lane comes in to bat it away at the All-Star 40-yard line, stopping that clock with 48 seconds to go on the incompletion. And the Cowboys go to the huddle with 3rd and 3 at the All-Star 49-yard line with 48 seconds left to play. And Morton brings them forward as again he goes to the eye, a 4-3 defense against him on the part of the All-Stars. Butkus and the linebackers in very close. Here's Morton fading. Screen pass. Thrown. Hill dumped behind the line by Butkus and Aldrich. Butkus was on as Butkus and Aldrich came blasting through there. And a loss of 3 yards back for Cowboys. 49-yard line. 4th down. 6 yards to go. And the Cowboys have called their 2nd timeout with 36 seconds remaining of the first half. 36 seconds left to go. At halftime, the Cowboy coaches, Tom Landry will be on. Also, the quarterbacks, Roger Staubach, will see action in the second half, and Craig Barton, who's been in the all the way in the first half, will be on for KNUS. With 36 seconds, the Cowboys, having used 2 of their 3 timeouts, the Cowboys will have it from the Cowboy 49, and I think, yes, 4th and 6, Tony Fritsch is going to try a 56-yard field goal. He missed a 59-yarder earlier, and it was brought back a long way, and now Fritsch is given a 56-yarder to try from the Cowboy 49-yard line. And it's going to be held for him, and it's put on by Danny Reeves, booted by French, and no good, and into the end zone. The All-Stars will take over on the 20 with 27 seconds left to play. All-Stars lead it 14-3 as that ball will come forward to the 20-yard line where the All-Stars will have it first and 10 on their own 20. 27 seconds. The crowd electrified a few moments ago as George Gipp ran 92 yards with a Marv Bateman punt for an All-Star touchdown. Ran through the entire Cowboy team. He got blocking, but mostly it was Gipp running. Sensational. He was Notre Dame's first All-American. The All-Stars on that line, first and 10 as the second quarter and first half begins to fade away. 27 seconds left. And here's Bull positioning his men. He has Nagurski deep and feeds to Jim Brown. Good for 2-3 yards. The clock stops at 19 seconds as the Cowboys are calling their third timeout. And that's the last one. KNUS bringing it to you. And in the timeout, we'll mention that Ken Bell and Grammy Emma, America's most famous radio morning team, on between 7 and 10 every weekday morning on KNUS. The new home also of Academy Award-winning actress Dorothy Malone, now a member of the KNUS news staff, of Rod Roddy, he of the great controversies. Most talked about FM station in America, KNUS. As that clock runs inexorably on, ball with a second and eight as 4-3-2-1 and the half ends with the Stars ahead 14-3. All-time All-Stars 14, the Cowboys 3. KNUS at halftime.
KNUS, Dallas.
Bart Mclendon here in the Dallas Cowboy locker room. The scene here is somewhat subdued, of course, but it looks really like business as usual. Tom Landry is over there huddling with his two quarterbacks, Morton and Staubach, just a few feet away. Over in the far corner, it looks as if Jim Myers, the offensive line coach, is diagramming a play for his team as Neely and Manders and Nylon all huddle around him. Equipment manager Jack Eskridge is handing out new and dry jerseys to all the players. Well, it looks like the quarterback meeting has broken up. Now, let me see if I can get Tom Landry over here.
Tom, can you come over here a sec?
Cowboy head coach Tom Landry. Tom, the Cowboys are down 14-3 here at halftime. And you've got Roger, of course, coming in to quarterback the second half. What should we expect for the second half? Have you changed your game plans at all?
Well, I think basically the thing that we've got to do is try to figure some way to defeat this great defense that they've thrown up against us. We haven't been very successful in scoring the first half. I think with Roger in there, we'll tend to move a little bit more now, tend to roll out, get away from the strong rush of Marchetti and Eller and Nomalini and Stoudemire, who's putting pressure on us, although they haven't trapped us very much. But I believe if we can get outside on them, then we can start them moving a little bit, and we should be able to find some holes.
Tom, much of the first half is centered around big plays, two in particular, really. One, that great goal line stand by the Cowboys when the All-Stars had first and goal from the Cowboy one-yard line, and the All-Stars didn't score.
Well, of course, it was a real great goal line stand. Actually, to stop people like that, you have to have a great effort out of everyone and the ability to come up with a big play in that situation will tend to turn a game towards you.
And the second big play, George Gipp's 92-yard punt return to make it 14-3.
I believe on any All-Star team, when you have such great stars, and the specialty teams become very important to the outcome of the game, because you have such great return people. And when you have that much ability catching the football, then something's going to happen, and it's already happened to us the first half.
Any major surprises the first half?
Not really. I do feel that we would score. I feel like that we should have scored possibly in the first half more than we have. Hopefully it will turn around the second half.
Thank you, Tom. I know you've got to get back with the coaches. Good luck in the second half.
Well,
I guess the Cowboys' main hero of the first half had to be Charlie Waters with two interceptions, both saving what looked like sure touchdowns. Charlie, come on over here, will you? Cornerback Charlie Waters. Charlie, except for that one interference call you had called against you, you had a sensational first half. What about that first interception? Did you think you could break it all the way?
Well, the old four ran it deep down and in. I just, we were in a zone defense, and I was looking at the quarterback, and I just read the ball thrown, and I went for the interception. I was lucky to get to it.
Did you have any trouble making your way down the sidelines, or was it pretty open?
Well, you're supposed to stick to the sidelines, but I thought I could make it all the way, so I cut back to the inside and got a couple more extra yards, but I didn't think there was much chance of getting all the way.
As a cornerback, give me your impressions of the all-star offense, if you will.
Well, he's by far the greatest of all football players. You know, when you look at the backfield, he's got Thorpe, Grange, and Jim Brown, and Unitas and Boss. You know, what can you say? I think with their running attack that they're putting on us now, the new box formation that they put in, the new... The,